Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video we are going to discuss about slow frequency hopping and fast frequency hopping difference. So what is the basic difference between them and what are the applications of those, we will be discussing in this video. So if you are new to the channel, please guys do subscribe, and if you like our work, we'll hit the like button. Okay, so let's move on to our topic, slow frequency hopping versus fast frequency hopping. So as we know that hopping is something like, suppose if you are having data like this and we are dividing the frequency, that is our bandwidth, into different frequencies. So 1, 2, 3, these are the frequency. So this is frequency axis and this is time axis. So T1, T2 and T3, these are the time hops. So 1, 1 we will be transmitting here, 1 again, 1, 0 will be transmitting here. If it is something 0, 1, then 0, 1 will be transmitting here. So if this is our data, then 1, 1 will transmit in this frequency, that is third frequency. So 0, 1, 1, 0 will transmit in the second frequency, 0, 1 will be transmitting in the first frequency, so that no one can jam our signal or they can decode our signal without knowing this pattern. So this pattern is known by only us, that is where we are in what frequency we are transmitting the what data. So if someone knows this pattern, then they will be able to decode the signal. So that pattern will be known by only transmitter and the receiver. So they can so intent and receiver can receive the data or decode the data. Okay, so that's about hopping. What is the meaning of hopping? So if you want to know more about this, then you can check my video. So I have made a detailed video on that, and with diagrams I have explained, so you can check for that. So in this video our intention is to differentiate slow frequency hopping and fast frequency hopping. So first one, in this multiple symbols are transmitted in one frequency hop. So in slow frequency hopping, multiple symbols, suppose this is our one data, this is second and this is third, so color differentiates them. So in this, in one symbol rate or one time period, we are sending multiple data, that is first one and second one. So this red color data and this is the black color data, we are sending in the same time period. So in this period also we are sending two datas, means here the data rate is greater than the symbol rate. So in this, multiple hops are required to transmit one symbol. So here what we are doing, multiple symbols means multiple data we are transmitting, so same data we are transmitting in the multiple frequencies. So this is some data here, black color, so we will transmit half data here, then half here, another half here. So that the jamming of the signal becomes more difficult. So fast frequency hopping means higher frequency switching here. So frequency is changing in greater as compared to the symbol rate. So in this also, so this blue color data we are sending in the three frequencies. So here one and here another. So in this the hopping rate is higher than the symbol rate, here the hopping rate is lower than the symbol rate. So one or more symbols are transmitted over the same carrier. So this is one carrier, or two symbols are transmitted in the same carrier. So in this, one symbol is transmitted over the multiple carrier. So this is one symbol we are transmitting in the F2, F1. So one symbol is transmitted over multiple carriers, that is F1 and F2 in this case. So here two symbols are transmitted in the F1 frequency itself, or F1 carrier. So symbol rate is equal to chip rate. So here symbol rate will be equal to chip rate, as one data will be completing transmitting in the one frequency. Here the hop rate is higher than the symbol rate. Hop means frequency changing rate. So frequency changing rate is higher than the symbol rate, because one data we are transmitting on the different frequencies. So hop rate is lower than the symbol rate, again this, and hop rate is greater than the symbol rate here. So a jammer can detect this signal jammer can detect this signal if carrier frequency is known. So if carrier frequency is known, because one data is completely transmitted in the one frequency, jammer can detect. A jammer can't detect this signal because one symbol is transmitted over multiple frequencies. So one symbol is transmitted over multiple frequencies. If someone knows F2 frequency, then he can't know F1 or F3 frequency where it is jumping. So they can't detect this signal. Thanks for watching.